This is my Tandy 1000SL. It is an XT-class computer that was introduced in 1988. It has 640K of RAM. And this one has an NEC V30 processor running at 8 MHz. That's an enhanced version of the Intel 8086. And it has 5 8-bit ISA expansion slots. And I've done a couple videos about this computer previously, but I have some new hardware installed in it. In addition to the hard drive on a card, I now have an EGA video card. It's actually EGA or VGA compatible, but I have it switched into EGA mode because I have an EGA monitor here, which I found at the recycling center a couple months ago. It's a Tandy EGM1 enhanced graphics monitor. You can see by the sticker on the back of the case that was made in December 1986. And I have it apart because I was making some adjustments and the controls are hidden inside and they're not accessible from the outside, so you have to take off the case to adjust it. But of course you have to be careful because this thing has 25,000 volts going to the CRT, so you want to stay clear of that while it's on. And I also have a sound card installed. This is my Sound Blaster Pro. I'm actually the original owner of that card. I got it for my birthday many years ago. I originally had it in a 386 PC, but now it's in this Tandy 1000SL. And the reason I have these two cards installed is because I'm using this computer to play mod files. Those are music module files first created and used on the Commodore Amiga series, but you can play them on a PC as well for a program like this, Galaxy Music Player, also known as GLX. It claims to be the world's fastest mod player because it can play these files on such a low-end system like this. And this monitor is actually very nice. It has a very bright and crisp image. After tweaking the controls a little bit, it works perfectly. This monitor also gives you a button to turn everything green, like an old monochrome monitor, because some people found that easier on their eyes. So it has a green button here that says text, so you can switch it back and forth between full color and monochrome green. And I had to use it because the GLX program does not work with the onboard CGA video. It requires at least EGA. So it's playing music on the Sound Blaster Pro card. It's mixing at 22 kHz for the 4-channel mod files, and it can also play 8-channel mod files, but I have to decrease the mixing frequency down to 16 kHz to get it to play on this system. And it is playing in stereo, so I'm going to put the monitor and the computer back together and I'll give you a sample of how it sounds. Slight change of plans. I had this monitor turned off, and about 15 minutes later, a huge cloud of smoke started coming out of the top of it, and you can still see it coming out. So I guess that's the end of the Tandy monitor. I could hear it crackling, and this is a hard power switch, so it was not connected to AC power when this was turned off. So I guess something still had a charge in it, probably one of the capacitors. And it just, something in there burned up. So much for that monitor. The funny thing is, it didn't smell like burning electronics. I'm sure many of my viewers have accidentally smelled burning electronics, so you know what that smells like. It smelled like burning wood. It smelled just like when somebody has wood burning in their fireplace. So that was quite interesting. So while I'm still clearing the smoke out the window, I'm gonna set up another monitor here because the show must go on. So the replacement monitor is this 1988 Mitsubishi Diamond Scan, which as you can see is working perfectly fine. This monitor is actually compatible with anything from MDA and CGA to EGA, VGA, and even Super VGA. And it even has a composite video input on the back, so it's a very flexible monitor. but here it's displaying EGA. So finally now you can hear the mod files being played on this Tandy 1000SL.